with the remaining problems. The first one, a certain metal surface illuminated with monochromatic light of wavelength lambda the stopping potential for photocurrent is 3V0 if same surface illuminated with light wavelength two lambda stopping potential is 3V0 the threshold wavelength for that surface is 3V0. If the same surface is illuminated with a light of wavelength 2 lambda, stopping potential is V0. The threshold wavelength for the surface is. So we have from Einstein equation, EV is equal to HC by lambda minus HC by lambda 0. So we can write V is equal to HC by E into 1 by lambda minus 1 by lambda 0. So in this equation, for the given first case, lambda, this V is 3V0. So for first case, we can write 3V0 is equal to HC by E into 1 by lambda minus 1 by lambda 0. For the second case, stopping potential is V0 and wavelength is 2 lambda. So we can write V0 is equal to same again HC by E into 1 by 2 lambda minus 1 by lambda 0. Okay, now dividing these two equations, we get 3 into this one, 1 by 2 lambda minus lambda 0 is equal to 1 by lambda minus lambda 0. Now multiplying this, 3 by 2 lambda minus 3 by lambda 0 is equal to 1 by lambda. Now writing this side, 1 by lambda into here 3 by 2 and it is all minus 1. 3 by 2 minus 1 equal to 1 by lambda 0 into this is 3 minus 1. So 1 by 2 lambda is equal to 1 by lambda 0 into 2. That implies lambda 0 is equal to 4 lambda. So the answer is the threshold wavelength for that surface is 4 times the wavelength lambda. So lambda 0 is equal to 4 lambda. Next one, A 5 watt surface source emits monochromatic light of wavelength 5000 Armstrong when placed at 0.5 meter away, it liberates photoelectrons from the surface. When the source is moved a distance to a distance 1 meter, the number of photoelectrons liberated will be okay, 5 volt source emits monochromatic light of wavelength 5000. When it is placed at 5 meter away, it liberates photoelectrons from the metal surface. When the source is moved to distance 1 meter, then the number of photoelectrons limited will be. Here it is something logic. Here, this is 5 watt surface. That means it is the intensity of the light. But its wavelength is 5000. So the number of, here you are asked to find the number of electrons limited. So by the law of photoelectric effect, number of electrons emitted depends only on intensity. Okay, so number of electrons limited emitted will depend on the intensity of light incident on the metal surface. But the intensity of light incident on a particular surface depends upon inversely proportional to square root of the distance between the source. That means intensity of light incident on the surface is inversely proportional to square of the distance between the surface and the source. So using this formula we can calculate. So that is I1 by I2, that means intensity of, so and that we can write, one minute, the number of photon emitted depends, photoelectrons emitted depends on intensity, that inversely proportional to 1/d². So we can directly write n is proportional to square root of inverse square of the distance. So we can write n1 by n2 is equal to d2 square by d1 square. So that implies n1 by n2 is equal to D2 is, here it is given as 1 meter by 0.5 whole square, that is 2 square. So N1 is equal to 4N2, or N2 is equal to N1 by 4 times. That means the number of photons decreases by 4 times the initial value. Now, problems based on matter waves. One of the problem is, you take this problem. Now this one, third one, the energy of a particle at absolute temperature T is of the order kb into t. Calculate the of a neutron, the energy of a neutron at absolute temperature T is of the order kb into t. Calculate the wavelength of thermal neutron at 27 degrees centigrade given kb is equal to 1.38 into 10 power minus 23 joule per kelvin. So, the energy of a neutron at absolute temperature T is the order of kBT. Calculate the wavelength of thermal neutron at 27 degrees centigrade given kB is equal to this one. So, already we know that the de Broglie wavelength of a particle, moving particle, is h by mv, or we can write it as, in terms of kinetic energy, we write it as square root of 2m into k. 2m into kinetic energy k. But here in this problem, the energy of the neutron is a function of kBT, is a function of temperature, and relate given that at a temperature T is of the order kBT. So given that energy of the particle is kBT, that means instead of k we can write directly kBT. This implies the wavelength of the particle is h by square root of 2m into, in terms of energy we can write kBT, so kb into t. So lambda is equal, now substituting all the values here, m is given that it is neutron, neutron means its mass is equal to that of proton, so we can directly write 6.625 10 power minus 34 by square root 2 into m is 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 into kb value is given as 1.38 10 power minus 23 into 300, because the temperature T is given as 27 degree centigrade plus 273, that is 300 k. Now that is 6.625 10 power minus 34 by, that is 2 into 1.67 into the square root of these ones into 10 power minus 27 minus 23, 50 plus 2, 48 writing minus 24, that is these will get cancelled, minus 10. Sorry, we have to write this 3 also, into 3. This is approximately 6. 6 into 1.6 means 9.6. 9.6 into this 1.38 approximately, it gives rise 9 into 1.5 means 13 point something. That is 6.625 10 power minus 10 by square root of, that value is 13.86. And that is 6.62 3.72 into 10 power minus 10. So this is approximately 1.78 10 power minus 10 meter or 1.78 armstrong. The next one, now fourth one. A particle A of mass m and initial velocity V collides with a particle B of mass m by 2 which is at rest. The collision is head on and elastic then the ratio of de Broglie wavelengths lambda A to lambda B after the collision. Here in this problem we have to find the de Broglie wavelength of two particles and by collisions. So you have to use two principles, collision principle and de Broglie wavelengths. Okay, assume that given that particle of mass m initial velocity v collides with a particle b of mass m by 2 which is at rest. Collision is head on and elastic. So the ratio of de Broglie wavelengths of lambda A to lambda B after the collision. Okay. Now, given that there is a collision between these two particles, so by a collision means law of conservation of momentum. So we have that formula m1 v1 plus m2 v2. This is the law of conservation of momentum in the case of collisions. So now, if you take given the first particle A, second particle B, initial velocity of the first particle is V. So writing that, we write m into V plus m by 2 into 0, this is at rest, second particle is at rest, is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2, but m2 is nothing but m by 2. Here we can write like this. So this is the total momentum before collision equal to total momentum after the collision. So equating these two. Now from this we can cancel out this m. So 1 minute. So we can write mv is equal to mv1 plus m by 2 v2. So cancel out m, implies v is equal to v1 plus v2 by 2. This is one equation we get. Next, given the collision is head on and elastic, so for a perfectly elastic collision, the relative velocity of approach before collision, ratio between the relative velocity of separation to the relative velocity of approach is 1. That means v2 minus v1 by u1 minus u2 is 1. If it is elastic collision, the relative velocity after ratio of relative velocity of separation to the relative velocity of approach is 1 for elastic collision, and this is 0 for inelastic collision. So given that is collision is elastic, so we can write this condition. Already v2 minus v1 as we can write, but u1 is v and u2 is 0. From this we can write v2 minus v1 is equal to u1 minus u2, that is v minus 0. So we have another condition, v is equal to v2 minus v1. This is second condition. Now, first condition and second condition, equating these two conditions, we can write v2 minus v1 is equal to this equation, v1 plus v2 by 2. Okay, now, writing this v1 and so v2 minus v2 by 2 is equal to v1 plus v1, that is v2 by 2 is equal to 2v1. So v1 by v2 is equal to 1 by 4. Okay, now we get this condition. Now going to the de Broglie concept. Now the wavelength is equal to h by mv. So after collision, you are asked to find the ratio of de Broglie wavelengths after collision. So after collision, their velocities are v1 and v2. So for lambda a, we can write h by m into v1. And for lambda 2, we write h by, mass is m by 2. So m by 2 into v2. Okay, now we have to find the ratio lambda A to lambda B. So lambda A by lambda B is equal to H by MV1 into H M by 2 V2. This one, okay. So this H get cancelled, M will get cancelled. That is V2 by 2 V1. But we have V1 by V2 ratio as 1 by 4. That is 1 by 2 into 4. Reverse, okay? Into 4. That is 2. That is lambda A by lambda B is equal to 2. Now the next one, fifth one. An electron of mass m with initial velocity v bar is equal to v naught I bar, where v naught is greater than 0, enters an electric field E is equal to minus E0 I bar, where E0 is also greater than 0 at t is equal to 0. If lambda 0 is its de Broglie wavelength, initially, then its de Broglie wavelength after a time t is okay. An electron of mass m with an initial velocity v is equal to v naught I bar enters an electric field E is equal to E naught I bar at a time t equal to 0. If lambda naught is the de Broglie wavelength initially, then its de Broglie wavelength after a time t. Okay. That means initially the velocity of this particle is this one. That means here I bar indicates it is moving along x axis. So the magnitude of this velocity is V0. So we can write lambda naught is equal to H by M V0, because it is already given lambda 0 is the de Broglie wavelength initially. So we can write like this. Now it enters into a electric field of strength, this one. So when a charged particle enters into a magnetic field, it's the force experienced by it is F equal to EQ. As you know, force is equal to EQ. So here given it is an electron, so we can write small e into E bar. So but as charge of electron is negative, it moves opposite to the field direction. Field direction is in negative x axis, but this force direction will be in positive x axis. So we can write like this also, minus E into this one, minus E naught I bar. This is F bar. Okay. So this equal to minus, E0 I bar. Therefore, from this we can write F equal to MA, that equal to E naught by I. So acceleration is equal to E naught by M into I bar. This is acceleration vector. Now final velocity we have V is equal to U plus AT. Final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus AT. So final velocity is equal to, initial velocity is V naught I bar plus A is minus E naught by M into T I bar. That is the final velocity. So this can be written as V naught plus E naught by M T whole into I bar. That means the magnitude of final velocity is the term in these brackets. So now if you write lambda is the de Broglie wavelength, then it is h by m into v. That is, you have to write this value, v naught plus e naught by m into t. Now taking this v naught as, that means h by mv naught into 1 plus e naught t by mv naught. You can write like this. But this h by mv naught is lambda dash. So we can write this as lambda is equal to h by mv naught. This total term is lambda naught. So lambda naught by 1 plus e0t by mv naught. So this is the de Broglie wavelength after a time t. Now the next one, electrons of mass m with de Broglie wavelength with a de Broglie wavelength lambda fall on the target in X-ray tube the cutoff wavelength lambda naught of emitted X-rays is okay, the electron of mass m with a de Broglie wavelength lambda falls on the target in X-ray tube, the cutoff wavelength lambda of the emitted X-rays is. Now, as we know, the energy means electron is moving means E is equal to P square by 2m. So implies P is equal to energy of the electron is P square by 2m, but its de Broglie wavelength lambda is h by p, implies p is equal to h by lambda. Given that the electron has de Broglie wavelength lambda, so its momentum is h by lambda. Now substituting here, the energy of the electron is E is equal to p square by 2m, that is h square by lambda square into 1 by 2m, that is h square by 2m lambda square. This is the energy of the electron. Now this electron hits the target in X-ray tube, so the cutoff wavelength of the emitted X-rays is. So when all these energies converted into X-ray photon, then we'll get maximum kinetic energy, maximum frequency, that is minimum wavelength. So this equal to, that means this energy is converted into an X-ray, means h square by 2m lambda square is converted into h nu max, that is hc by lambda 0. Okay, now equating these two, we can cancel out h. That's only. So we have to calculate lambda 0. So we can write h by 2m lambda square is equal to c by lambda naught. So lambda 0 is equal to 2m lambda square c by h. Or we can write lambda 0 is equal to 2mc lambda square by h. That is the relation between the de Broglie wavelength and the X-ray emitted.